The Elevation of the Almighty, Bobby Lashley's second WWE run. First of all, I want to apologize for, while I didn't upload that much video during this past few weeks, well, because I took my vacation and, well, I actually had a lot of time watching again pro wrestling and do some new videos about it. Well, since there's a lot of videos circulating about anyone and anyone on the internet. So, well, here we are. Well, we're discussing Bobby Lashley's second WWE run. And from the guy who actually had multiple storylines. And also, well, people actually had a dream match between him and Lesnar, which is, I'm not sure if it is possible by now, but yeah. You get the point. So Bobby Lashley's return at first, well, he returned at the Raw after Mania 34, which, well, at first, well, he was put into multiple storylines that didn't go anywhere. Well, they also produce a segment which is highly criticized. Well, you know, the Bobby Lashley's sisters, which was produced by WWE and with Sami Zayn and Bobby Lashley on that said segment. So, well, during that segment, well, they had these guys wearing some girl clothes, and the segment for the internet wrestling community, they think that it's actually one of the worst segments, next to Bayley's This Is Your Life with Alexa Bliss. So yeah. And while he feuded with Sami Zayn, Kevin Owens, and even defeated Roman Reigns on one point, while he speared Roman Reigns on that match during his return, defeating the former universe, well, the one who's actually chasing the Universal Champion at that time. And so yeah. Bobby Lashley, well, he found a new character after Lio Rush joined him, and well, he did this poses with the crowds, which, well, during the matches, Lio Rush is actually screaming Lashley, Lashley, Lashley every time, every segment, every time that he gets a mic. And because of this, well, later on, because of this new heel turn, well, he got the Intercontinental Championship, which, well, when he got the championship, he got a run out of it. He's actually a two-time Intercontinental Champion. So yeah, after that, well, they actually, well, also during that, they feuded with the Shield, while him and McIntyre and Corbin, I think, well, they feuded with the Shield after, well, McIntyre, Ziggler, and Strowman actually disbanded. Well, this pre-feuded with the Shield, and they have this mini stable, and then that storyline. And then, well, he lost the title to Finn Balor, which, well, after that, he was, well, doing not that much on the main roster, but he is dominating regardless. And during this time, well, people are actually asking, well, what is he doing on television? This is not his full potential. Well, the IWC is asking that and this and that and this. So after that, well, in 2020, and actually in 2019, the end of that, they find this storyline with Lana, with Rusev, with Lashley, which, well, it started because Rusev actually had rumors with Maria on the storyline basis that he's actually the father, which doesn't make sense on the storyline note. So, well, later on, Lana cheated with Rusev, and he actually had segments with Bobby Lashley, which, well, if you watch their kiss, well, you will see that memorable moment with Randy Orton laughing on that segment. His reactions actually sold that segment alone. So, well, after that, they had this feud before Rusev actually got out of WWE. So when Rusev actually was out of the WWE, WWE still continued the storyline with Bobby Lashley and Lana until WWE actually found a brand new gem under storylines that is actually highlight one of the most highlight things on Monday Night Raw, and that is the birth of the future Hurt Business when MVP actually confronted Bobby Lashley and Lana and actually convincing Lashley where does this guy go, where does the former monster, well, he actually manages in TNA before. Well, it's a call back to their old stable, and well, they formed this stable, which, well, it is actually one of the most focal points of Monday Night Raw. So the Hurt Business dominates everyone who stands in their way. Bobby Lashley, MVP, and then later on they were joined by Shelton Benjamin and Cedric Alexander. So what happened? Well, at first it was only MVP and Bobby Lashley, which MVP only accommodates Bobby Lashley as his manager or as his tag team partner during that time. Well, because they were still forming the stable, and yeah, during this time he got his WWE Championship match against Drew McIntyre, which he lost. But although he lost, well, he looked dominant even though he lost the feud. Actually, this is the birth also of the Hurt Lock, which, well, he adopted the Monster Lock before, used by Chris Masters, and now he is doing it on a daily basis on Raw episodes, which he actually used this as his finisher for a while. Well, yeah. And after that, well, the Hurt Business is about business, and they are actually doing things on Monday Night Raw. Well, when the Retribution debuted, well, they don't have the best storyline. Well, they have the best introductions. They have the best, well, you know, well, the WWE actually was invested on them before. Before they actually become complete jobbers for the Retribution. Well, when since Ali was actually joining them, well, yeah, everything turned into something that isn't nice for the group. So, well, after that, well, the Hurt Business dominated the Retribution. They destroyed them in storylines. And also during that time, Bobby Lashley won the US title. During his feud with Apollo Crews, MVP's feud with Apollo Crews, the Hurt Business got the WWE United States Championship. Which, well, during the time, Bobby Lashley is just dominating the Midgard division. Which, well, he's actually dominating the said division. And then his partners, Cedric Alexander and Shelton Benjamin, won their tag team championships. And also during this time, well, also, well, Shelton Benjamin won the 24/7 and then lost the title. Well, because of the 24/7 championship rules, that's why, well, he joined the Hurt Business, because, well, they helped him defeat R-Truth on one occasion. So yeah, well, the Hurt Business is dominating Monday Night Raw. And well, during their entrance, well, it actually becomes, well, more interesting, and the group is more interesting because, well, they remind us of former stables that are actually dominating Monday Night Raw on many occasions, and their success does not stop there. So when, well, they had this segment with MVP and The Miz on a backstage segment, which MVP, well, they actually talk, which later on in the Elimination Chamber 2021, they helped The Miz capture the WWE Championship, which is the second run of The Miz for the WWE title, which did not last that long. Well, because you know who is the new WWE champion? You're right, it's Bobby Lashley, the guy who actually helped The Miz on his championship cash in during that time. Well, he actually destroyed Drew McIntyre after the Elimination Chamber match, thus setting a new feud again with the Hurt Business and Drew McIntyre. So the Hurt Business got most of the gold except for the United States title. Well, Bobby Lashley lost it to Riddle. And yeah, regardless of that, it was actually a blessing on the Hurt Business part. Well, because they captured the WWE Championship. So, what is a mid-card title to the main championship of the show, right? So now, rumors are spreading that Bobby Lashley is heading to WrestleMania and to feud with Drew McIntyre. Which, well, that's maybe their direction. I don't know if it's going to be the WWE champion going into WrestleMania. So let's watch WWE Raw and see what will happen on the storylines on the Hurt Business. Thank you and have a nice day. Again, this is Mike Rato and peace.